kids. How are y'all? I hope all of y'all are doing great. So welcome back to Unit 1, Welcome Our World. Okay, today we will learn about can or can't with your teacher, Miss V. But before that, don't forget to click on the subscribe button below. Okay, now can or can't. When we will use can or can't? It is used to express the ability of doing something. It means you want to tell someone, I can do this, I can do that. So, ability of doing something. For example, I can cook. My sister can't cook. So, when you can do something or you can't do something, you will use can or can't. Okay, and then to express the feelings. For example, you are having love on the cat. So you say, I can touch, I can taste. Okay, so you want to express the feelings, you will use can or can't. And for to request or offer, you want to ask someone, you want this or not. Okay, so you will use can or can't. For example, can I get a glass of water? Oh, can I bring you a bowl of noodles? So you want to offer something, you want to ask something, so you will use can or can. And then, like for example, in the classroom, you want to go to toilet, so you will use may I go to toilet or can I go to washroom. Okay, so you will use can. Okay, now let's recall can and can't. Okay, look at this picture. What is the boy doing? What is the boy doing? Yes, dive. Okay, the boy is diving. So we can use he can dive. The sentence is he can dive. Okay, now let's look at another picture. What are they doing? Yes, they are playing basketball. So how would be the sentence? They can play basketball. Okay, now look at this picture. What is the boy doing? He's supposed to do homework, but he cannot do the homework. So what will be the sentence? He can't do homework. Yes, he can't do homework. Okay, next. What are they doing? Supposed to be swimming. They should be swimming, but they cannot swim. So the sentence will be, we can't swim, or you can say, they can't swim. Okay, so that's how we use can or can't. Now let's recall. Okay, for I, he, she, it, they, we. So you can use all these personal pronouns, personal pronouns to use can or can't. So for example, I can swim, he can do karate, she can paint. It, you can use it for animals and plants. It can dive. Let's say for a fish. So the fish can jump on the water, right? Okay, so they can play football, we can sing. Okay, the same goes to can't. Okay, I can't swim, he can't do karate, she can't paint, it can't dive, they can't play football, we can't sing. So you use can or can't to express the ability of doing something. Okay, now let's look at how to ask questions. Okay, look at the picture. What is the boy doing? Yes, the boy is singing. So the question should be, can he sing? So when you want to ask question to someone, you will use the can in the front. Okay, can he sing? So look at the picture. Yes, he can sing, right? So the answer will be, yes, he can. So you will write yes, and then you can write he can. Okay, so yes, he can. Okay, next, look at the next picture questions. Okay, look at this picture. What picture is this? Okay, it's an ugly doll. Okay, ugly painting. Okay, so how will be the question? So the question will start with can. So can she draw? Okay, can she draw? Look at the picture. Is this picture shows that she can draw? No, right? So you will write no, she can't. Okay, so just write this she, and then can will change to can't because of this no. So no, she can't. Okay, look at another picture. Huh, what are they doing? They cannot swim. So the question will be, can they swim? No, they can't. Okay, now let's practice this question. Okay, what is the uncle doing? Suppose I think should be playing football. So how will be the question? Can he play football? Okay, is this uncle can play football? No, right? So no, he can't. Okay, now look at this picture. Okay, what are they doing? They are talking about something. So let's look at the question. Can you do experiment? So the question is, can you do experiment? Yes, I can. So remember, kids, when you are asking someone in front of you, you will use you. So when you are answering, you will use I. So you cannot use can I do experiment. You cannot ask yourself. You have to ask the person in front of you. So you will ask you. So can you do experiment? So the answer will be yes, I can. Okay, now it's task time. Look at the picture and answer. Okay, look at this picture. What are they doing? Playing football. So how will be the question? Can they play basketball? So the question is, can Luke and Simon play basketball? The answer, yes, they can. Okay, now look at this picture. Okay, what is the boy doing? Yes, karate, but I don't feel he is doing karate. He knows how to do karate. So the question is, can Sam do karate? So you for sentence, you can't write can Sam karate. Karate is doing. So the verb will be do. So can Sam do karate? No, he can't. Okay, next, look at this picture. Okay, singing. So the question is, can Sarah sing? No, she can't. This is a girl, so you will use she. Okay, so if you want to use Sarah also, okay, no, Sarah can't or she can't. Okay, and then look at this picture. Yes, dive. So can Alicia dive? Yes, she can. Okay, so now time to recall. Okay, can and can't. Look at this picture. Okay, what is the kids doing? Yeah, they can't swim. Okay, and then what is this boy doing? He can sing. So this is normal sentence structure. Okay, can and can't. Okay, now question, asking question. Okay, how to ask question for this picture? Yes, what is the boy doing? Playing basketball. So can he play basketball? So the answer will be yes, he can. Okay, look at this picture. Homework. Can he do homework? No, he can't. Okay, so I think that's all for today, class. I hope all of you understand today's lesson. Thank you, and please don't forget to click on the subscribe button, like the video, share the video, and subscribe the video. Thank you, kids. See you. Bye.